Let's learn about types of muscle contractions. Muscles make our bodies move in many ways. Let's begin by learning some muscle contraction terms. In a muscle contraction, the agonist is the muscle producing the movement. The antagonist muscle opposes the movement. Here's an example. In a biceps curl, the elbow flexes to lift the weight. This results from contraction of the biceps muscle. Since the biceps is producing the movement, we say the biceps is the agonist muscle. The muscle opposing elbow flexion is the triceps. We say the triceps is the antagonist in elbow flexion. The biceps curl exercise also has two phases. When the weight is lifted, the elbow is flexed and the biceps shortens. We say the biceps is contracting concentrically. In concentric contractions, the muscle shortens against a load. During the second phase of the exercise, the weight is lowered. The biceps is now lengthening against the load. We say the biceps is producing an eccentric contraction. In an eccentric contraction, a muscle lengthens against a load. Here are a couple of other terms. The origin of a muscle is where it attaches to the relatively immovable end of a joint. The insertion is where the muscle attaches to the more movable end of a joint. For example, the origin of the biceps muscle consists of two attachments. The long head of the biceps attaches to the supraglenoid tubercle of the scapula. The short head attaches to the coracoid process of the scapula. The insertion of the biceps is at the radial tuberosity of the radius. Some other terms are prime mover and synergist. The prime mover is the primary muscle performing a movement. The synergist is a muscle that helps the prime mover perform a movement. Here's an example. In shoulder abduction, the deltoid performs most of the movement and the supraspinatus helps out. So we say the deltoid is the prime mover and the supraspinatus is a synergist. There are three types of muscle contractions: isometric, isotonic, and isokinetic. In an isotonic contraction, the load remains the same, but the muscle length changes. This exercise is an example of an isotonic contraction. The subject can move the weight, but the weight does not change. In an isometric contraction, the force can vary, but the muscle length remains the same. Pushing your head against your arm is an example of an isometric contraction. You could push hard or soft, but your head would not move. In an isokinetic contraction, both the force and muscle length can vary. What remains the same is the speed. Walking on a treadmill can be an example of isokinetic contractions. The force can vary with different inclines, and the leg muscle lengths can change, but the speed of the exercise remains the same. We hope you've learned something about muscle contractions, and see you next time.